In these times of searing heat waves, it's hard to imagine what life would be like without indoor climate control. That's one of the reasons why a career in maintaining and installing climate control systems is one of the fastest growing occupations today. The Air Conditioning Technology Program at Georgia Northwestern Technical College trains students to safely install, maintain, troubleshoot, and repair the various heating, ventilation, cooling, and refrigeration systems that control air quality in many types of buildings. The program is taught at the Floyd and Walker County campuses of Georgia Northwestern Technical College.
The career opportunities are excellent. It's a job career that can't be outsourced. The equipment has to be brought here, even if it's manufactured overseas, to be installed and maintained and serviced. Right now I'm getting probably 6 to 8 job opportunities every single week.
Michael Meyer is the program director of the Air Conditioning Technology Program at Georgia Northwestern Technical College and the instructor at the Walker County campus. Michael says that climate control is more than a luxury or comfort, it is a necessity and a safety requirement.
It's such a part of our life that there's no way that I don't think we could exist as we know it without refrigeration and air conditioning, especially here in the South, especially with the weather that we've had, you know, over the last summer and a couple of winters ago. It's a necessity, not really a luxury, for people to have it in their comfort and their well-being.
It's pretty diverse. They have a lot of different equipment in here. You know, they have a lot of different types of equipment, different brands, pretty representative of what you'll probably see out there once you start doing it.
Rich Gibson is a student in the Air Conditioning Technology Program at the Walker County campus of Georgia Northwestern Technical College. Rich was in the home improvement business and decided to enroll in the Air Conditioning Technology Program because he was attracted to the stability of the field.
Some months was busy and some it wasn't, so I kind of looked around for something that would be a little more steady. You know, people are always needing heat and air and refrigeration. If their air conditioner goes out, they're going to find the money to get it done. So I wanted something that was going to be a little bit steadier year-round.
Heating, air conditioning, refrigeration mechanics and installers mostly work in residential homes, schools, hospitals, office buildings, or factories. There are also a wide variety of other settings outside of residential and commercial services that require trained technicians.
I have a past graduate that works on the refrigerated trucks that go up and down their roads delivering things. And when I worked in Atlanta, a lot of the students would go to work for the railroads for refrigerated railroad cars. When I taught down in Florida, I actually had a lot more marine down there, and some of them ended up working on cruise ships.
The program has an advisory committee made up of industry professionals from locally owned and operated businesses who provide input on program needs and expectations for the students once they graduate. The committee also provides equipment donations to the program and hires many graduating students.
Our student base is across the board, young guys, older gentlemen. We teach them to build ductwork, how to read a set of gauges, change motors, insulate duct, typical power tool usage, learn how to use electrical meters and understand the electrical background using meters. And when they come out, a lot of my guys have gotten jobs in the heat and air industry, the refrigeration industry, and typically it's at a beginning level, but they're able to progress pretty smoothly.
According to the U.S. Department of Labor, employment of heating, air conditioning, and refrigeration mechanics and installers is expected to grow 34% from now until the year 2020, which is much faster than the average for all occupations.
It's estimated that a third of the working force in the field right now will be retiring between now and the year 2020. And the estimate need to replace for the growth as well as the retiring folks is about 350,000 technicians nationwide.
Heating, air conditioning, and refrigeration systems are becoming more complex. As a result, employers in the industry prefer applicants with a post-secondary education. With a large percentage of the workforce getting ready to retire, graduates of the program can expect to find continued employment throughout their career.
There are plenty of jobs in this industry. It's a very diverse field and it's needed worldwide. And so there's never been a problem. Anyone looking for work in the industry can always find it. It's a field not going to go away.
To find out more about GNTC's Air Conditioning Technology Program, visit our website or give us a call for more information.